focusing on these individuals, the surveillance camera found them fleeing. Afterward, if you could try to locate who they were, where they were from, as much as possible.
I understand this would be an intrusion upon their welfare to some degree. They were local. We have them in some residence within 25 miles of this place. They have traveled to other places as well, but these are local individuals. Direction.
Thank you. So, what can you say about their motivation for defacing, for attempting to destroy the Georgia Guidestones, which had some rather, shall we say, controversial etchings on the stones, a guide for a new age, so to speak. The monument, as you brought up before, has been defaced previously. It had graffiti placed on it that had to be removed and so forth. Although it was not widely known about, not famous per se, what motivation did these individuals have? What was their driving force to do this?
It would be of the same. It would be a prank. It would be to deface. It would be something to cause some destruction here. But this was way beyond their expectations. They did not expect that it happened to happen. They were attempting to, let us say, deface, or here to see if there was a vibration in the stone, to see if there would be any weakness. They did not expect what happened to happen. Direction.
Thank you. I have had you locate this area before, and you commented on a small time capsule buried on the site, mentioned by an inscription on one of the stones. In that previous communication, you mentioned the time capsule being a roughly egg-shaped object. After the destruction of the stones, excavations were done at the site, but it has been reported that no such object was found. If you can examine this, there was excavation done, and the remaining stones that were standing were toppled over and removed, which was strange because it was only about 12 hours after the blast happened, later on that same day, which would make this a crime scene, very atypical that they would do this to a crime scene without roping off the place and taking careful inventory of an examination of the stones. So this was odd. But excavations were done at the site, but it has been reported that no such time capsule was found. When you examine this from later on in the day, was indeed nothing found there, or was something dug up here that was not reported?
You can expect that the reason this was dismantled was because of that of the power surge itself, and that of fear that there was something going on that no one understood as to the origins or that as to the cause. As such, there was an attempt to, you would call this, dismantle a power station, if we could use those terms, and understand that if there was energy released that no one knew, the triggering mechanisms, the extent of the force, or that of the source of this, call it force, then you can understand that there would be some reason to dismantle it or to prevent any further explosions or calamity. Those who would be in charge of this were quite fearful of further experiences. To the question, this sphere or this shape was left. We don't see it being extracted, but we do see some sort of on the surface, and then something crushed it, you say. There are other little, smaller stones with drawings on them or markings on them, symbols on them, you say. These are still evident on the site or near the site itself. But out of the larger capsule, if you would call it, doesn't seem to be evident in our inspection at this moment. Direction.
Thank you. You had previously, in the communication where I asked about these stones the first time years ago, you had located the person who had authorized the construction of these stones, who has attempted to keep himself secret for all this time. And the question would be, did the person who authorized these stones to be built, was he ultimately behind this destruction of the stones?
We don't have the entity anywhere near the place. It appears like he doesn't exist anymore. Direction.